It is with deep sense of honor and gratitude that I stand before you to deliver some introductory remarks during this official opening of the 39th Standard Summit of Heads of State and Government. I thank you most sincerely for honoring our invitation. Allow me to thank the government and people of the United Republic of Tanzania for the warm welcome and for accepting to host the 39th SADC Summit. We are humbled by the hospitality extended to all of us and the excellent facilities put at our disposal, a true demonstration of Tanzania's commitment to SADC cooperation and integration. On a sad note, allow me to express our deepest condolences to the government of the United Republic of Tanzania and people and the families affected by the fuel tanker accident in Morogoro, which occurred on the 10th of August 2019. We stand in solidarity with you in this difficult moment. May the souls of the departed rest in eternal peace. We wish the injured a speed recovery. Your Excellencies, the macroeconomic position of our region remains critical for the realization of the goals that we have set for our region. The general economic environment has been relatively stable during the year. Economic growth averaged at 3.1% in 2018 compared to a growth of 3% in 2017. Botswana, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Madagascar, and Tanzania observed strengthened economic growth, and only the United Republic of Tanzania made a GDP growth of 7% in 2018. The capital GDP for the region improved slightly from $4,004 in 2017 to $4,171 in 2018. All member states except one recorded positive growth in per capita GDP in 2018. There was an improvement from only the five member states, namely Botswana, DRC, Mauritius, Seychelles, and Tanzania, that reported positive growth from 2017. The annual inflation rate decreased to an average of 8% in 2018, from 10.1% in 2017. This slowdown in inflation is associated with, among others, favorable weather conditions in some member states, low demand pressure, and stability in exchange rates. Botswana, Eswatini, Lesotho, Madagascar, Mauritius, Mozambique, Namibia, Seychelles, and South Africa, and Tanzania met the inflation target rate of 3 to 7%. The downward trajectory in investment and savings registered since 2014 continued in 2018. The region recorded investments of 22.8% of GDP in 2018 compared to 24.4% in 2017. Botswana, Lesotho, Seychelles, Tanzania, and Zambia performed above the regional target of 30% of GDP for investment. On the savings side, the region remains subdued at 19.9% of GDP in 2018, lower than 20.6% realized in 2017. Only Botswana, Mozambique, and Zambia attained the regional saving target of 10% in 2018. The fiscal deficit averaged at 3.1% in 2018 compared to 4.3% of GDP in 2017. Angola, DRC, Mauritius, Seychelles, and Tanzania met the fiscal deficit target of 3% of GDP in 2018. Public debt maintained an upward trend across all member states in 2018, where the region's public debt increased to 48.8% of GDP, slightly above the 47% recorded in 2017. The number of member states that met the original target of public debt of 20% of GDP remained constant at 11 in both 2017 and 2018. Najua Kiswahili hakijaa lugha rasmi ya SADC, lakini kwa vile niko Tanzania, naomba niseme kwa kifupi nimesema nini, ili wananchi walio wengi waweze kunielewa. Nilichosema, nimesema kwamba uhimilivu kwa uchumi ni nyenzo muhimu sana katika maendeleo. Nimetoa takwimu ya jinsi nchi wanachama zilivyokizi vigezo vya uchumi mpana wa sana, tuna vigezo. Na takwimu hizi zimeonyesha kwamba nchi wanachama zinafanya vizuri na Tanzania ni miongoni mwa nchi wanachama ambazo zinafanya vizuri. Na kwa kipekee kabisa Tanzania ni nchi peke yake ambayo imeweza kufikia kigezo cha kufikia 7% ya ukuaji wa uchumi. Kwa hiyo naomba tujipongeze, lakini pia naomba tuzipongeze nchi za SADC kwa ujumla wake kwa kujitahidi katika kufikia kigezo hiki. In spite of the progress made as demonstrated by the macroeconomic indicators, Tropical Cyclone Idai and Kenneth had devastating effects on some of our countries, but in particular, unions of Comoros, Madagascar, Malawi, Mozambique, South Africa, and Zimbabwe, resulting in unprecedented loss of lives and livelihoods, and the destruction of our property. I would like to express our deepest sympathy to the countries and people affected by Cyclone Idai and Kenneth. SADC responded swiftly by releasing $500,000 to the three countries that were mostly affected. And they also launched a regional humanitarian appeal. May I extend our gratitude to His Excellency Dr. Hage Geingob, the chairperson of SADC, for his timely response. And the member states, united agencies, and other partner institutions, civil society organizations, the private sector, and the individuals that supported the affected member states during these challenging times. As a result of the national and the regional humanitarian appeals, a total of $203 million, translating to 41% of the required $491 million, has been mobilized. As a long-term strategy, SADC in the process of operationalizing the Disaster Preparedness and Response Strategy and Disaster Response Plan. As climate change intensifies, climate-related disasters are predicted to increase in frequency but also in severity, further compounding the increased threat to the health and the well-being of human and non-human species worldwide. As such, there's a need for the region to undertake interventions to lessen the impact of these disasters. The region also needs to undertake interventions to reduce its footprint on climate change through, among others, adoption of clean technologies to reduce carbon dioxide emissions, combating deforestation and increasing reforestation to enhance carbon reduction measures. Your Excellencies, implementation of the 38th SADC Summit theme of promoting infrastructure and youth empowerment for sustainable development that you adopted in 2018 August in Windhoek, Namibia, progressed very well. Attention was on the amplification of youth voices through the SADC Youth Forum. In this regard, numerous activities were implemented that resulted in the development of a framework on promoting youth innovation, entrepreneurship, and leadership. This was in the recognition of the importance of youth and the need to mainstream youth empowerment in SADC programs. To this effect, youth empowerment will remain a continuous SADC agenda. May I thank His Excellency Dr. Hage Geingob, the chairperson of SADC, for his vision and for overseeing and guiding the implementation of the 38th Summit theme and for pushing it forward as part of the regional integration and development agenda. It was a theme and it's going to be remain a SADC agenda as we move forward. We thank you very much, Your Excellency. Excellencies, peace and security and stability are essential in creating a conducive political and a social environment for livelihood and to thrive the business to operate and flourish. During the year, the region maintained its enviable record of peace, security, and stability. Furthermore, consolidation of democracy has remained on a right trajectory. Since your last meeting in August 2018, six member states, namely the DRC, Eswatini, Madagascar, Malawi, South Africa, and Zimbabwe, conducted elections which were credible and peaceful. Where there were electoral disputes, legal processes were followed in handling such complaints. Electoral disputes are a healthy part of democratic process, and when subjected to due process of the law, they reinforce the legitimacy and credibility of the democratic system, as we evidenced during the year in our region. Your Excellencies, once South Africa enjoys peace and tranquility, terrorism and other transnational crimes continue to be matters of great concern. Organized crime also poses a significant threat to peace and security, and also undermines regional economic integration. It is therefore imperative that certain member states continue to cooperate and undertake joint initiatives to address this menacing of great concern to all of us. Gender-based violence also continues to adversely impact on the socio-economic development of our region. A study undertaken by the SADC Secretariat on gender-based violence in the region, among others, shows that gender-based violence is a common phenomenon in SADC. Preference rates vary across member states, with physical violence ranging from 6 to 34%, which is very high. Sexual violence from 4 to 26% is equally high. And emotional violence from 15% to 37%. With everyone's commitment, we can eradicate this unacceptable practice of gender-based violence.